Welcome to the Confidence in You podcast, designed to help you build confidence and create positive, lasting change in your life. And here's your host, Helen Luxford.
Hi there, and welcome back to the podcast again. Thank you for being here and taking some time to work on your confidence and self-esteem. Today, I want to just reflect on a book that I read recently, The Four Agreements, A Practical Guide to Personal Freedom by Don Miguel Ruiz. In his book, he talks about four agreements or principles to live by, and I thought they were really profound, so I thought I would share my summary of the book with you today. The book talks about the four principles based on an ancient Toltec wisdom, and that if you live by these four principles, you can find personal freedom and let go of self-limiting beliefs that are no longer serving you or that may be contributing to you feeling the way you do or impacting on how you live your life. It brings awareness to these four areas of life. So the principle behind the book is that throughout our life, we grow up and we make agreements with ourselves, with others, and with our spiritual guides, if you have one, and with the life that you live. It talks about how these agreements are based on what other people have told us about what we've learned as we grow up and how others have guided and shown us in our life, and how we've been shaped by our upbringing, and that these agreements are not necessarily our own. It describes that by following the four principles or agreements outlined in the book, you can become more aware of and change those agreements that are embedded in you and that aren't serving you anymore. Now, some of the agreements we have in our lives are serving us well, but some come from a fear-based approach, and it is those that aren't serving us and that may be limiting or holding us back. And that's what the book talks about. It talks about agreements that come from a place of fear can drain our emotional energy, and they can chip away at our self-worth and diminish our self-esteem and our self-confidence. So a fear-based approach contributes to the formation of our self-limiting beliefs and can cause us to live a life conforming to others' wishes, desires and expectations, whether we know it or not, at the expense of our own happiness, joy and freedom. Now, if we've grown up with these fear-based approaches, we don't know any different. So this book helps to identify and highlight where you can acknowledge and change these agreements with yourself if you choose to do so. In the book, it outlines that to find joy, happiness, and freedom, you need to release yourself of and let go of societal norms and the fear-based agreements that unconsciously influence our thoughts, beliefs, mindsets, and really ultimately how we act and behave. Because if we don't recognize these habits that are keeping us small and conforming and stuck, then we are inadvertently choosing to stay in that world. But if you recognize these things, then you have awareness. And with awareness comes choice. And you have a choice to change how you approach life, if you want to change. The underlying theme of the book is that most of the time you have the ability and choice to transform yourself by identifying, changing those negative or fear-based thoughts that arise in your mind. And we all have them from time to time. You can choose to look at things differently and then notice how you see the world in a new way. A new way, a way that you can now see opportunities instead of roadblocks. Or if you see a roadblock, you can now see a way around the roadblock. So by understanding and using these four principles in your life, you can shift your mindset and improve your well-being. The premise of life is that our external world is an extension or reflection of our internal thoughts, of our internal world, of our embedded thoughts, beliefs, values, and attitudes, and that we only see in others what we see in ourselves, consciously or unconsciously, and that ultimately determines how we behave and engage with others. Because your beliefs and thoughts determine how you feel. How you feel influences how you act. How you act determines your outcomes or results. And your results influence your thoughts and beliefs, and the cycle continues. So let's have a look at the four agreements or principles discussed in this book. This is my summary and interpretation of the book. So there's four agreements, and we'll run through them one at a time. They are: be impeccable with your word, don't take anything personally, don't make assumptions, and always do your best. So agreement one, be impeccable with your word. It's a fairly simple premise to be impeccable with your word, but how does that play out for you and what does it really mean? My takeaway is to be aware of how powerful words are. Observe the language you use every day. Is it more optimistic or pessimistic? Is your cup half full or half empty? I've worked with people that their cup of life has a crack in it and it's always draining, and so it's always half empty or less. And that drains energy being around people like that. So for most of us, we just go about life, we just talk, we don't really think about what we're saying and how we're responding or engaging with others, because thoughts just come to us and words come out of our mouths. However, everything in life is energy, and interactions are energy exchanges. Even the self-talk you have with yourself is an energetic exchange with self. What you're thinking and saying has an impact and influence on you and those around you. Our thoughts and words vibrate at a certain frequency, and depending on what and how we're speaking or thinking, it will attract into our life at the same vibrational frequency or energy. So have you ever noticed when you're having a bad day and you're in a bad mood and more bad things happen to you? Like when you get up in the morning and you're rushing and you might spill your coffee, and then you're running late, and then you miss the train or you get a speeding fine, all because you let the spilt coffee influence your mindset and mood, and this attracted more of that same frequency of things and events into your sphere. Now, these things happen in life, but it's how we process them. So processing it, knowing that that's happened, okay, I've spilt my coffee, taking a breath and resetting your energy will make a difference to how the rest of your day goes. And the same thing goes when you think about yourself or you speak about others, or you put people down, you put yourself down, or you make fun of others, or you have a joke at someone else's expense, or other people have a joke at your expense. Things like these and other negative thoughts are heavy and destructive. And guess what? Even if you're thinking or talking about someone else, you're still attracting that energy towards you. So I challenge you to pick up on those negative or heavy thoughts. And also be kind to yourself. If you catch yourself having a low thought about yourself, just change it. Just change it out. Change that inner critic to a neutral or a positive thought. And this is something you can practice doing. The more you're aware of it and practice changing it, the easier it will become. So here's my tip. I use an acronym OCCE, OCCE. Observe, catch, change and engage. So observe your thoughts and words. Just become aware of them and notice how you're thinking and what you're saying. Catch any negative or low vibrational thoughts or words. Just catch them. And then change them out. Change them out to something different, to something neutral or positive. And then engage differently with a new approach. Give that a shot. See how it goes. Agreement 2. Don't take anything personally. The second one highlights that our mind takes things personally and how to handle hurtful treatment from others. Our mind has a strong sense of self, of who we are, and that is all you need to focus on. However, if you've been brought up thinking that you're not good, you're not smart, you're dumb, etc., etc., then maybe you need to observe, catch, cancel, and change those thoughts. And once you do, focus on what you believe to be true of you. Focus on not taking things personally. Maintain a strong sense of self and build your self-esteem and self-confidence so that you don't have to rely on external validation. So if you've been brought up in an environment where you have been told negative things, just check in with yourself, because deep down inside, maybe you know they're not true. Maybe you know that you can do that thing, that you are smarter than they think. And don't take things personally. Because when we take things personally, we're operating in a low vibration, and normally that involves feelings such as hurt, anger, envy, sadness, jealousy, etc. And we don't want to be down there in those low vibrational feelings. We want to be in the high vibrational feelings of self-worth, of confidence, self-assurity. So if we engage when others are thinking or talking about us in those low-level energy, we're giving it more energy and we're attracting more of that into our lives. So if you're feeling that you're taking things personally, just check in with yourself. You know, deep inside, what you are, who you are, and how good you are. So don't let other people's low vibrations come into your sphere. Just let them wash over you. Just think of it as a wave rolling in and just washing over and washing away, and then back yourself. build your confidence and your sense of self. So my tip for this point is, remember that these thoughts and others' opinions can only hurt you if you let them. If you hold on to them, engage with them, then they'll stay around. If you allow them to wash over and naturally let them disintegrate, you can do this by remembering the great things you've done in the past and recall those feelings associated with a great past event. If you feel these feelings creeping in, these low-level feelings, acknowledge them and let them go, because holding on to them isn't serving you. That inner critic isn't serving you. So just acknowledge the inner critic and say, thank you, off you go on your way if I don't need you anymore. And recall something in the past where you felt good and good feelings associated with a past event. By remembering the good things you've done in the past, the things you've learnt, reflecting on your journey so far and how far you've come, and acknowledge that you've gained along the way, and remember that life is a learning journey and that we're all continually learning. So be kind to yourself and just grow a little bit each and every day. Agreement 3, don't make assumptions. Making assumptions can lead to all sorts of things, because when we assume something, it can create tension and stress because our mind rarely fills in gaps with positives. It looks for negatives and creates stories in our mind when we assume. And that can cause things to spiral out of control, and it can relate to suffering and conflict because our interpretation or assumption is our internal thoughts and beliefs. So how can we know that what the other person is thinking or meaning if we don't check in? So stop making assumptions. Do a check-in with yourself to see if you are reacting and assuming, or are you responding by asking questions, seeking clarification, gathering more information? Because the way to avoid assumptions and assuming is to seek clarification, ask questions, and engage with the other person. So think about this. Has there ever been a time where you've been in a shop and someone looks at you and you think that they're thinking something negative about you? Probably. But how do you know that? You don't, because you're just assuming. So my tip for this one is look at the word assume and how it's spelled and what it stands for. Because if you break it down into three sections, the first three letters are A-S-S, ass, then U, then M-E. So don't make an ass out of you and me when you're assuming. Catch and cancel out those assumptions. Take stock and do a personal check-in about what do you know to be true, not what you think or assume, and if you need more information, ask. Agreement 4, always do your best. Now, for me, I think this is the most powerful agreement or principle. Always do your best, or do your best as much as you can, because that is all you can do. You can't do someone else's best. You can only ever do your best. And you know innately when you've done your best or when you haven't. I know sometimes when I haven't done my best because I'm a bit tired or, you know, just can't be bothered. But stop comparing yourself with others and just look at you. Work on being your best you, doing your best in each situation and always showing up for yourself. Work towards your goals and what's important for you, and compare yourself to you of yesterday. So stay in your lane and work towards your finish line. Don't worry about what others are doing or how far they are on their journey. Just because they're doing XYZ doesn't mean you should or need to, even if you want to follow in their footsteps. The way they got to where they're going is their journey, and the way you're going to get to where you're going is your journey. And they might be doing XYZ today, but you don't know how far they are on their journey and what they've done beforehand to get themselves into the position they're in. They might be well advanced in that area and you might be just starting out. So just do your best for you. Just be aware of when you do and don't do your best, and strive to do your best each and every day in whatever circumstances come up for you. Doing your best today might mean that you're full of energy and you can get through all your tasks, duties, chores, errands, the running around, everything you have to do. But tomorrow might be a very different day. You might have to deal with an unexpected circumstance tomorrow, which means you can't do everything on your list or you can't do everything you wanted to do. But if you do your best in those circumstances, you're still being true to yourself and doing your best on that day in that situation. And remember to take care of yourself. Do your best to take care of you. Remember to fill up your cup, to find time to do things that bring you joy and refill your energy, because you can't help others if your cup is empty. And on the days when your cup is only 50, 60, 70% full, and that is all you have to give, that's okay, because that is doing your best on that day. You're giving all you can in that situation. So be kind to yourself and know that it is okay to have different levels of best for different circumstances and different situations. Just be true to you and do your best as much as you can. So my tip on this one is to keep a journal and write down what worked well, what didn't, and reflect on it each day. So do a little journal entry in the morning and evening or just once a day and think about what happened today. Write down where you did your best and when you didn't, and learn from those experiences. Think about what was it that stopped you from doing your best in that situation. What are your energy drainers and can you eliminate or minimize them? Look at your journal and reflect back on it and just notice, what is it that stopped you from doing your best on that day? Was it that you put other people's needs ahead of your own? And think about what makes their needs more important than yours. Was it that you overcommitted to things? Was it that you couldn't be bothered? And what caused you to feel that way? How can you take time out each day to fill up your cup so that you can be energized as much as you can most of the time? If you do your best in any given circumstance, you will build your confidence and avoid self-criticism, self-judgment, and regret. And that's all you can do. You can only do your best. And that's okay, because you know when you've done your best and when you haven't. And that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed my summary of this book, and I thank you for sharing the podcast with family and friends, and I'd really appreciate you following me and giving me a rating on iTunes so we can reach more people together. Until next time, let your light shine.